Hi, I'm Ellis, and you're watching D-Combat.
Hey, Max.
Yeah?
Did you see this new streaming platform called Disney Plus?
Have I?
Yes.
You've been using my account for months.
Did you see all the movies on it?
Oh, yeah. A ton of movies from my childhood.
I was looking through them, and, what's a D-Com?
Oh, that's a Disney Channel original movie. That's a movie that I watched a lot during my childhood, and I'm sure Ellis has.
I have.
I'm sure
I have.
Alec hasn't.
I've never.
Did I watch them? Yeah, damn right I did. And that's why we're here, because we have all differing views on what is the best Disney Channel original movie. We are doing a bracket-style tournament to determine the best DCOM movie. And what do we call this show, Ellis?
D-Combat. Well, I assume there's going to be like a...
Put a riff in.
Yeah.
Alec, play the riff. I'm going to ruin your career.
I know you are. It's going to be a terrible.
There he goes. There he goes.
Cello.
Every episode, we are going to watch two movies. And then the fourth person who hasn't seen these movies decides, after an argument between those present, which one is the better movie. And that goes on in the bracket. There's going to be 16 movies. Max, Ellis, and myself are all going to pick five, and Alec is going to pick one based on no knowledge of any of this stuff.
The Dark Horse candidate.
Or a wild card.
And if Alex wins, then something bad happens to us three.
Which I do not want to happen.
I doubt it will, but if it does, one of us has to die.
That's only fair, I think.
So, we've got all these movies written down here. We've got a poster board. We're going to do the draft.
Can I burp one more time? Okay, we're good.
And now, it's time to figure out who goes up first for the draft.
How are we going to do that?
Right. Well, we spilled a bunch of cards out of our Disney Scenic box.
Oh.
Alec picked up a few.
Well, hold on. We?
Max.
No.
Alec picked up a few and is going to read one of them to us. And whoever can answer it is to go first.
Are you guys ready for this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Who plays... Jack Frost in the
same... Martin Short.
Nice. Fuck me. I had no idea.
This is to see who goes second. Now.
Yes. Now.
In what movie does Hilary Duff sing What Dreams Are Made Of?
The Lizzie McGuire movie.
Damn it. I was about to
you
say,
say the Hilary Duff movie.
The Hilary Duff movie.
So Max, me, and Ellis.
Yeah, that's awesome.
All right.
Let me consult.
Let's begin. We have, 107 movies here?
My memoir.
Yeah,
my Mighty Morphin memoir. My first...
Paper.
Draft pick is The Titan High School Musical. My number one pick.
Well, if Max is going to bitch out like that, then I'm going to go High School Musical 2
wow.
for my Titan pick.
The linchpin Titan pick. Who could possibly beat the two top grossing DCOM films of all time? Only my linchpin pick, Wizards of Waverly Place, the movie.
Whoa!
Shocker, huh?
I was reaching for something else.
I know you were. I know exactly what you were reaching for, but that is
I'm
not
shocked that Ellis would choose a bad movie.
That's, well.
What's going on here?
Wizards of Waverly Place, the movie, is, in my opinion, the best.
It's an unfocused piece of shit.
This is, Max, I believe you're up.
Oh,
for a second.
I have more picks. A blockbuster after my time, but still a good one. Lemonade Mouth.
Excuse me?
That's a good pick. I'll be
honest. What happened to you guys? Why are these being picked? Well, I'm going to pick the actual best DCOM movie ever. Wait. Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off.
Damn it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
that's
the best. Not going to beat that one.
Yeah, it's a really good one. All right, so my second pick is... Now I'm actually going to pick the one that you thought I was going to pick. It's Phineas and Ferb Across the Second Dimension. Is my second draft pick to go on the board.
My third movie is a movie that can be carried by its lead alone.
Wow, that's cool.
Wait, hold on. Can we guess?
Mm-hmm.
Nope.
Yeah, I have no idea.
So, Lindsay Lohan's Get a Clue.
Oh, yeah, all right.
These are some crazy movies that you guys are picking. This is not what I expected.
Well, you expected one of those, at least.
Marvel movies, eh?
I know it's right.
People like Marvel movies, people like superheroes, but what invented the superhero? Sure. Jack Kirby, Stan Lee? No. You know who invented the real superhero movie? Director
Robert Townsend.
Yeah, right.
When he made, or she made, probably he, because it's the 90s. Not because I don't think. Up and away.
You know, people talk about Iron Man. This is the first Disney-made superhero.
It is, baby.
Marvel movies. Some of the best movies out there. Specifically Doctor Strange. Because of time travel.
I forgot about that movie.
And who perfected the time travel genre but Jason Dolly.
He didn't make it, though.
He was in it. It's Minutemen.
My next pick is going to be the Even Stevens movie.
Yeah, okay.
I would have picked that if you didn't. Clothing's too tight, right?
I don't think so. I feel pretty good.
I want to go back to the 90s where everything was so big. Smart House, the movie about big clothes.
They do have such big clothes in that movie. Yeah. People say when you fall in love, there's magic in the air. But I'll tell you where the real magic is. It's at the academy where they go to school.
You're not going
to
say Avalon, are you?
No, it's
a magic school.
Yeah, it's a magic school. Okay. Now you
I was going
to
say that Avalon thing.
Now you see it. It's the fourth film.
Stuck in the Suburbs.
Yes.
Damn it. That was my last one.
I was going to pick that as well as my last one.
Yeah, well, I think we're
so
watching it tonight.
We got a lot of good ones that I want to pick from. Brink, of course.
Yeah, Brink, a great one.
You Wish, Close to Home. It's about wishing your brother didn't exist.
Yeah.
Going to the Mats, about Wayne Brady teaching a blind guy to wrestle.
That's a great,
while being blind himself.
That's a great film, a great one to pick.
I think I got to go Look at the Irish.
Okay. No, that was my other thing pick.
Gotta do
God
it.
Damn it. Okay.
I was already going to choose the other one.
I got to go back to the list now.
Oh, Tiger Cruise?
Yeah.
Did you think you were going to pick Tiger Cruise?
I'm going to pick Tiger Cruise. Give me that one.
Okay, well, put Look at the Irish under mine.
I'm going to pick Tiger Cruise, so we have to watch Tiger Cruise.
So that we have to watch.
This is not going to win.
But we're all going down with it.
Well, we figured out where all the smart money is, but let's figure out where the dumb money is. I get to pick one of these titles based off of just that, the title. Okay, so there's a pull to Camp Rock 2, The Final Jam, because it sounds apocalyptic in nature.
No other jam ever existed.
That
Where were you
great.
When the final jam
God,
happened?
God, I would love to watch Camp Rock 2 as a remake, but it's in the post-apocalyptic. We don't. It sounds boring.
True Confessions.
That's the one where Shia LaBeouf's retarded. Yes! Yes, dude!
The dumb money pick has locked in.
Yes, dude!
With True Confessions.
Yeah. Alec?
Congratulations.
So the draft has finished. And drum roll, please. The movie will be, drum roll, please.
So
drum roll, please.
So the movie, so the draft is complete. We have picked our movies. And for that our pick, we're done.
Drum roll, please.
we're gonna start off with Duncan's second pick, Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off.
Duncan's second pick, otherwise known as Duncan's actual first pick,
because the first pick had to go towards
DCOM movie. I had to pick High School Musicals or somebody else take it, because it might be Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off is my favorite DCOM.
That's fair.
High School Musical 1 or 2 is most likely the best.
High School Musical was a cultural phenomenon.
Orlando Brown is in this movie. I forgot about that completely.
Can you put that in there, Duncan?
Yes.
What do you mean to say, like Raven did when she was black?
I mean, I told you in the first interview. I mean, she gave me, and then I gave her some.
Alec, what do you think this movie's going to be about?
Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off. Eddie is the best player on the... No, I don't know how this is related at
all. Does it really throw you off that it starts with baseball?
It's really throwing me off, actually. I think he gets injured and takes up cooking or something.
Okay, well...
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Who's that?
Oh, it's him. That's Eddie Vedder himself.
Eddie...
Oh, he's making Eddie dog. Thank God.
That special effect was pretty neat.
That was a pretty good transition.
That was
Eddie
clearly
Eddie dog.
That was clearly an homage to 2001: A Space Odyssey when they throw the bone up and it becomes the spaceship.
Oh, I see. I remember this like I fucking watched this yesterday.
Oh my God.
It's all looks delicious. I want a binging rabbish of all everything.
That's good. That's true. That'd be great.
Of everything in this movie.
It's Edwina, the daughter you've always wanted.
Oh,
hi.
Hi,
I'm Edwina. I'm the little French chef from eighth grade.
Knock it off!
Oh, come on. Relax, Eddie. We're just teasing you. It's not like anybody thinks you're going to trade in your baseball mitt for an oven mitt.
If you haven't got it now, Alec, this movie's about being gay.
I got it. I got it.
You also know that line was in the trailer.
I was about to say, that's the line for the trailer. I know that that's the line that somebody came up with and then said, fuck, we should make a movie about that.
That's the entire movie, yeah.
So their goal here...
Yeah, to get the classes that they
to
want.
To get the computer class, because you play video games.
Oh, sure, yeah.
As their elective.
Oh, I'm not going to say it now.
Well, you said it earlier.
No.
You said it.
But see, look. He's covering the title.
Yeah, he makes them sign up for Home Ec 2.
He tricks them.
Welcome to Home Economics.
What's that all about?
He was still talking in that shot.
What's that all about?
And shut up. I'm going to Julian you up one side and back down the other. Am I making myself clear?
Not really. Watch Julian.
You finna get pegged.
Also, they made fun of her for coming prepared to class.
Well, maybe they did.
Okay, you
maybe
know.
They're shitty middle school kids.
They're shitty middle school kids. Rose didn't make fun of her. She's the only one. She's the only good person.
She's the only pure soul in this movie.
She's the only one that gets through Eddie's Million Dollar Cook Off unfazed.
Her hands unbloodied.
Yo, the Nutcracker soundtrack slaps.
Hey, you know what?
It cracks.
It cracks.
There you go.
What are you saying, Alec?
I was just going to draw another parallel to 2001: A Space Odyssey.
Please.
Here we go. Hit us.
Please do.
Slow motion.
Eddie's $2001 cook-off. Fuck this kid. Fuck this kid right behind him.
Why? What's he? Oh, he steals the purple.
What kind of kid is just like,
what a disgusting
kid.
It's quite a big announcement. It's huge. I've just gotten off the phone with the cook-off people. And, you know, they were so sweet.
Oh, Brown makes the best faces.
Oh, and the other finalist is Eddie Ogden.
Yes!
Eddie Ogden
in my finals?
Nani?
This is turning into Eddie's $1 million cook-off.
Cook-off thing? What's that about?
It's nothing. It's just a thing.
What could a cook-off possibly
I would love
be?
To write the script for this. It's just a thing.
It's a thing, Dad. You would understand.
What?
You don't
It's
cook.
A cook-off. What could it be?
Just tell me.
I've been racking my brain all night.
Not only is Eddie Ogden the first boy from Cedar Valley Junior High to make the finals, he's
also do they have a $1 million cook-off every year or something?
I'm just like making food.
He cook, he bad. Drum roll, please.
Just looking at you.
Here's outdoor lockers.
Yeah, what the fuck is
this
that?
This is chaotic energy right here. I don't approve.
Whoa.
It's also only 12 outdoor lockers.
That's so throwing me off.
Get in here. We got some serious cook-off training to do.
What the fuck are you guys doing?
Coming? I've got some work to do.
Can you stop?
I'm trying to cry.
Duncan, you're crying.
He's holding a fake baseball.
Hey. That's the only way he can do
that's
it.
That's how he has that gets it out of him.
Hey, come on.
They,
am I
the
eyes watering?
Yeah, they are. Really.
If he chose baseball.
He's good enough.
Because he's good enough. You'd rather read a cookbook than a comic book.
Comic books aren't related to baseball, though.
Whoa. Did you expect two, let alone one, food fight?
I expected one. I go into every DCOM with the expectation of at least one.
He doesn't tell me anything.
He doesn't tell you, or he's telling you things you just don't want to hear.
What's that supposed to mean?
Hey, Mom. Hey, Dad. Sorry I'm late.
I heard Dad about to learn a lesson, so I had to butt in.
Yeah. This dad keeps getting saved from character development.
Hey, I'm just trying to help. We don't need your help. We don't want your help. In fact, we don't want you. The better off
making
some
pies. Go home, Air Bud.
The contest here.
Yeah, that's what he's doing.
Right?
This is a weird way for.
So yeah.
Help.
Even when
hey,
he's.
Hey, go fuck off and cook, idiot.
Even when he's helping him, he's being an ass
he's
about it.
He's being an asshole about it.
Lord of the Rings.
That's what I did that at the beginning. I was going to say something about it, but. It's madness.
It's the Hobbit theme.
Can we save this for background music for my campaign?
What is happening?
This is very good.
Is a sensei about to arrive?
the salt and pepper flipping guy.
This has to be just from like back.
Everything pauses and he walks out like between all the frozen people. Eddie, a demon is coming to this cook-off. You must be ready.
There's one cheerleader.
Standing right next to the drum roll, please.
Sorry.
Okay.
Was he holding a baby?
He had her clothes.
It looked like he was holding a baby.
It did look like he was holding a baby.
Okay. I like the sequence of shots.
Where? All the chocolate?
Yeah, hurry.
Eddie, whoever heard of Dad? Okay.
Well, folks, this is it. Dad, trust me. I put Fruit Loops on chicken.
I'm trying to poison the judges.
They can't say I lost if they're dead.
Dad, just believe me. Time paused and a sensei walked out and told me I have to murder Bobby Flay.
You have to poison the Bobby Flay.
Don't know who Bobby Frey is, but
I don't know who Bobby. Don't we have to go Bobby Frey?
I'm still trying to figure that out.
Food fight!
Food fight!
Food fight!
It's Bridget Simmons!
I knew it. She deserved it too.
Because he won the love and appreciation of his father.
So you're gay and a failure.
That's what I was about to say.
I'm just glad that I finally know what a cook-off is.
It only took me participating in
it. He says, good job. Now, when's that cook-off going to happen?
What's that cook-off thing?
Hey, what about me? I'm the winner. I'm hungry, too.
Fuck off!
He moonwalks.
They always do the
get ready for that. Good. Get ready to see that a lot.
Yeah.
Get ready to see a lot of freeze frames.
Such a good movie.
So, what'd you think?
I really like it. It spoke to me because it's about a dude coming to terms with his homosexuality. So, it's mostly about gender roles and how they're kind of garbage.
It's about gender roles, but it's also, you gotta keep in mind, this is one of the few DCOMs that doesn't have a love interest.
That's true.
Interesting point.
Would you say the way it faces gender roles feels old or like still kind of applies right today?
It's
because I guess not many people would really care if you cooked today.
I think it's
that's kind of a cool thing.
I think the actual activity is arbitrary, and I think they chose cooking because they knew that it wasn't actually a girly thing.
And it's also cinematic.
They did have a curious. There was a lack of a necessary bad guy, I guess. I mean, they never depicted.
Yeah.
The bad guy was society that we live in. I told you this guy also directed Joker.
Yeah.
I don't think that's true.
You see the scene where it was at the cook-off, Eddie was sitting
across from Bobby Flay. You know Bobby.
And threw a baseball at him.
Just
Joker sitting across from Robert De Niro and yells, food fight.
Say that again.
Let's watch.
Hold on.
Let's watch Get a Clue.
We're going to watch Get a Clue.
Let's watch Get a Clue.
Got a little. Sorry.
Sing it.
Well, yeah, your wife. Only your wife can peg you.
What's it called when not your wife pegs you?
Okay, it doesn't happen.
Doesn't happen.
Movie. And I'm not supposed to.
Tell me what we just watch.
This is the best movie I've ever seen.
Now that I can borrow. It's Trey Cute, you think?
Trey Cute!
Oh, you saw it?
Maybe at the mall one time. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hedda Hopper had nothing on you.
Hedda who?
Hedda Hopper, he had nothing on
you. Hey, got you, babe. You got someone's hoochbush chutzpah. It's coming out your pajamas.
Of the CIA. With 10 years as a covert operations officer.
She can kill any one of you. She could kill you with a strap on.
And I wouldn't do anything about it. You can't stop talking about pegging.
That's Jim Halpert, right?
I was just about to say it's the guy from The Office.
Wait. No,
it does look like Jim Halpert.
I hope they get my good side.
Not her.
What?
That's you and me, Unc.
Which one are you?
I'm the imaginary friend.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh, what a... That was a...
What was the point?
Look at their outfits. That's the point. Target
But
audience.
She was like... And then it was
I like how she was in front of a crime scene.
Cut to fashion
this,
walk.
And now they're...
What the heck?
Is Jaws coming?
She's dressed like a goddamn widow.
Duncan.
It's worse than Jaws.
Don't flatter yourself. She's a lead suspect even without.
Don't flatter yourself, sugar. You're cute, but you're not that cute.
Why can't you just tell it like it is? She threatened him yesterday. We both heard it.
She didn't threaten
him. Oh, he did. Does have that accent.
Is he from Brooklyn or a goblin?
He's tall, mysterious, just your type.
That's not possible, Jen.
Tall, he's not mysterious.
He's not mysterious at all. There's nothing. There's literally zero mystery about that kid, except for maybe where he got that fucking accent.
Yeah. They, yeah. Water deep.
Fucking nerd. I'm a nerd for getting it. I'm a nerd for
you.
Laughing.
How dare you, Duncan?
Fuck you.
Like hell
this.
Yeah.
Because this is 9 years late.
I don't know why they cut to the shadow.
I had that
Stop
toy.
Listening device.
That's not what that is.
It's
a
motion detector.
Motion detector.
Yeah,
no, I know
too.
That one. That's not going to help. There's still a big ass camera there.
This is illegal.
This kid's a pervert. Everything he does is illegal.
Uh-oh, train's coming. Watch out. Help! I'm tied to the tracks!
And it cuts to a different scene.
What was that? Why was that evil?
It's the
ominous train.
He's helping her, yeah.
He's a fucking pervert.
Better watch the fuck out. She'll kick ya.
How's this guy at a private school?
I think it is a private school. That's why they were so hung up about, like, I'm going to be the one who stays here because probably pays better.
Oh, yeah, sure. Okay, that makes sense, actually.
And of course, she would go to a private school.
Yeah. But he...
He's the janitor.
Should we go in? I was born in this school. Raised by it.
Molded by it.
molded by the mop water. You were merely adopted the mop water. I was born in it. Molded by it.
I didn't taste tap water till I was but a man.
You know, I really like the sleuthing thing. I think I could be pretty good at it.
Did the cat fly through a window?
I think someone threw a cat at the window.
Oh, he was my boss.
I never liked that man.
Mother, please.
ISIS?
ISIS! He invents ISIS.
With him and a He's bunch crazy. Of cowboys made ISIS. And put it into a farm. Orlando Walker, maybe a wanted the teach is a leech! You're doing Josh Peck.
That was what I was saying. A sizable
reward has been posted. The teach is a leech! A leech! OLEACH!
Whoa! Wow!
I'm getting motion sick.
Yeah, no, but like, what was keeping her contained? That shot
that was not
so
necessary.
I didn't like that.
Her facial expressions.
Where
like,
are the Dutch angles come from?
Fuck out.
Is the hotel falling over?
I feel like this film is physically falling apart.
Yeah, what happened?
Never worth it. Did they forget about the British dude?
Hey, nope, there he is.
Oh. I summoned him.
Damn it.
They said that mid-air.
They caught it with
tape. They saw, they knew it was going to happen, I guess.
Food fight.
Fishy! Freeze, you're covered in cake. This is against the law.
Bye.
Bye.
Congratulations.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. See you.
Bye.
Get out of here.
Just a word. Fungi mean anything to you? Come on, Jen. My feet aren't that elite. Neither are yours.
My feet aren't that elite.
You said there weren't themes in this movie.
Yeah.
And if you can't find it, well, then you just have to get a clue.
And I start to say, and if something that tells me what I must do,
wake up, it's me, it's get a clue.
So what did you think of Get a Clue?
All right, so it was mostly just fashion shots.
I think I put this movie in the same category as Harriet the Spy in my mind. I was like, oh, young girls being spies, they're equally as good.
What's the, Alec? What's the running theme of this one, Max?
So
it is the.
What are your final thoughts before you pick a movie?
Judge somebody based on how rich you think they are.
Sure,
it is that. That is the theme. It's very.
It's kind of there. It's, so, Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off had a coherent plot, which was nice, and it had a plot that worked into its theme. In terms of like acting and special effects, I mean, there wasn't that much need for special effects, and they didn't really do. See, the other movie went overboard for stuff that they didn't need to. They kept doing Dutch angles, they kept doing all this other shit, and it was completely unnecessary. Not that any of this is necessary, but
case the
show
not that the show isn't necessary.
I think I'm ready to make a call.
Drum roll, please.
What?
Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off.
Yay!
What? What a surprise!
What a come-from-behind victory Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off got.
Okay, you can't make any come-from-behind jokes after all the pegging we talked about.